All right, so today, again, I'm going to be a global economic discussion. I don't know, the level playing field, very simple. You have United States and their prices, and you have China or Asia and their prices. You know, at least, you know, we have to match those prices. We can't allow China to be much cheaper over here. Because here's America with their prices, and they'll just go away, you know. Because this will be the purchase price. So it's a pretty simple understanding. Then we can't do that, you know. It's like just giving the United States away, saying these here Chinese America, or these here Chinese states, or these here Asia states of America. You know, we turn into their organization. We turn into their government. You understand? We give everything away. So we have to maintain. I know it's been 20, 30 years, and I haven't even entered into this discussion of politics, but you have to maintain the same price. So you have something for sale here in America, and it's $7. It has to be, if that import is bringing it in, it has to be $7 also offered to the people. If you want to be nice and play like we're all friends and pals, and you want to compete here in America, $7 to $7. That's it. Same product, $7. You know, whatever, you know. But then we're like, oh, this is free democracy, isn't it? Free exchange of enterprise and blah, blah, blah. And you come up with a better version, and so it becomes $5? Yeah, that's the way it's been going. $5. It even becomes cheaper in many places. So, yeah, so this is our big, big problem. Having it produced elsewhere, cheaper. And yeah, and isn't that a nice little pillow that everybody gets to sit on here in America? That, oh no, we don't have industry. We really don't have industry. We just have maybe fulfillment centers or something. You know, that's enough. We just survive with fulfillment centers. Yeah. Because industry is ugly. We all know that. Industry is ugly, creates, you know, pollutions and all of this garbage. So, yeah. So it has been a nice little cozy for a long time. To live like, you know, that we are better. We don't need to have ugly factories near us. It's been very cozy. So here we are in America making glamour products. You know, the glamour drink, the glamour makeup, glamour products. So when we're making glamour products for sale, that's the illusion. The American people are under an illusion that they can even buy that glamour product. They have to have it. So they will buy that extra $2 drink or that extra $2 whatever, plate, whatever, they'll buy it because they're glamorous America, the glamorous Americans. So that's how it's been surviving, is that illusion. So if when the glamour money runs out, when you don't have the glamour money to buy the glamour products, and I mean, like, well, forget it. I can't buy the extra $2 whatever drink. I can't go that route. Those glamour companies fall by the wayside. So we lose them. And whoever was putting on the beautiful graphics and make it look all like this is American Pie, whatever. Whoever was doing that, they go out of business. That little cutesy company. It made that really spiffy little drink that you had to have. but you can't afford it any longer. So then it goes like that. You know, there's the undertone, and so you're like, well, okay, so you get the other one. And the other one is just cheaper. Everything is just cheaper. You start buying cheaper products, cheaper products, cheaper products. And so that's what's going on. Is the illusion is just, it's crashing. You know, the illusion of American glamour products. You know, can I buy Rustica bread, you know, for $7 sometimes, a loaf? You know, can you buy that, you know, just because it has a little olives in it and a little bit of sun-dried tomatoes? Can you buy that? The illusion is crashing. You know, so that little company that made Rustica bread is going out of business. So they have to offer less. And then they're starting to compete with, you know, just ordinary products. And so, yeah, so everything falls. Everything falls by the wayside. So that's where we're at. So looking at global, on the global, here's that $7 bread. No, they don't even bother with the $7 bread. I don't even know if they make bread. I don't think we get bread imported from Asia, but I wouldn't be surprised if many of the products that make the bread are imported from Asia, like certain types of flours, soy flours, blah, blah, blah. You know, a very low price. So yeah, I mean, I don't know. I'm really hounding Asia at the moment. I'm kind of mad at the whole thing. It's been going on for, you know, 20, 30 years. The welcome mat, you know, just the welcome mat of Asia. You know, here you can have it. You know, so anyway, I'm trying to figure out, okay, well, how do we salvage the situation? I'm like, well, what business? I'm like, well, maybe print businesses. Maybe that, you know, because we could have the major printing machines here without, you know, too much industry going on. And then the actual printed products. So maybe we're printers. Maybe we can make printing things, you know. That's a funny one. We could be the printers. And then I'm like, well, that's kind of weak, because that's really only here in America. That's not an export product. That's only really an import product. I mean, a localized America product. It's not import or export. It's just here, you know. It's isolated. So what other product? And then I'm like, oh, it would be so fun to be potters. We could be the potters of the planet, you know. That would be cute, but no, we can't compete with that. I mean, Limoges itself, even in France, is just like a joke. It's just like for a tourist drop-off visit. That's it. So no, we're not really potters. To compete, you know, with what you see at Walmart or whatever, or what is it, Walmart? Yeah, that store. No, I mean, there are millions and millions and millions of Americans. And they're buying products specifically imported from elsewhere, you know. They're not buying them that were here, built here, made here. So when we're looking at, like, a pottery house, that would be cute. But that's the glamour, isn't it? That's another glamour item. It's another glamour item. They had one in Colorado Springs, actually, a little pottery house. And I'm not sure how, you know, it's just like a tourist visit stop off. You know, that's all it really is. So it hasn't been allowed to expand, that type of thing. When in reality, you should have a large pottery facility in every city. A large pottery facility that supplies plates, glasses, everything. But that's not going on. Because we can't do that for the $7 to the $7 matching. It just does not work. It's more like, I guess they were like 19, the Americans ones were like $19 to what you would get in China for like, Malaysia, you know. Over here it would probably be like $7 itself. So yeah, it's $13 less. People are always going to buy it cheaper, you know. So America's only been pandering to the hyper-rich, You know, the hyper-rich. The hyper-rich who can afford the glamour products. So when we lose our hyper-rich, when we have less and less of our hyper-rich, you know, when we talk about consolidations, that means less and less hyper-rich. So when we have less and less hyper-rich, what does that mean for America? That means we have less glamour products that are being purchased. So because we have less glamour products being purchased, well, less hyper-rich, we lose our per capita, we lose all of that. Everything starts to slide just a little bit. Oh my goodness. So what else is there? I don't know. I can't find any other products. I'm sorry. And just internal products and matching, trying to match the GoDaddies. The GoDaddies that have just killed the internet, those types of companies. I don't think it's even possible. I mean, and I'm even looking at like the design business itself. You know, you charge per square foot on design. You know, when we have $1 a square foot being quoted as a design price, you know, it's outrageous, absolutely outrageous. When the rents are at $14, $15, that's an outrageous statement, you know, it's competing with Asia. And you know, you can't compete with Asia. You just cannot compete with Asia prices. So the only thing is certain markets can actually put their kudos in and continue. It's just outright racism. I don't want to hire Chinese. I don't want to hire Taiwanese. I don't want a Taiwanese company. So that's the only, even if the Taiwanese company is three quarters the price. Is that three quarters or a third of the price? I want it to be a third. Yeah, we'll say a third. So normally the design fee is $3 a square foot or $4 a square foot, you know, for a good remodel. And so we're looking at $1. Because guess what? All of the drafting, all of the actual work is being done back there. So if you have all of the work being done back there, it's a lot cheaper to pay those people back there, isn't it? So that business just goes by the wayside, you know. So drafting, drafters, you're competing with the GoDaddy syndrome of Asia. There's billions of people on this planet, just billions. So anyway, yeah. How rotten! So you're dealing with you hire an American company. It's going to be more money, and chances are, you're not a global type of person, meaning you're not into, I'm gonna hire the Chinese, you know, or I'm gonna hire India, you know, it has to be Americans, you know. So when you deal with this, I have to hire Americans. It starts to be that tinge ethnic denouncement, you know, we're denouncing these other people. It's terrible. It's not what America's about. We're supposed to be a global melting pot, and I guess that's just come back and slapped us in the face. Be nice, nice, nice to everybody when their prices are like, you know, heinously cheaper. So they just pulled the carpet out from underneath. All right, so what else was I going to say about it? Gosh dang it, global economics. Just global economics. Like I said, is there a way we can start an appraisal office with the government here of these here United States? An appraisal office, item for item. If a plate is coming in from Kuala Lumpur, is a plate that would be built here, made here, priced at $8. That one that's coming in from Kuala Lumpur has to be also sold at $8. That would be the appraisal office here and the government of these here United States to save industry in America, to save whoever makes the plates. So that type of thing would go on, you know, instead of, oh, that's so cute, that's so cute, another cargo ship, that is so wonderful. How much are the contents of that particular crate or whatever you call those things? You know, how much are the contents? You know, oh, wonderful. Only $5,000, you know. When here, built in America, that would be worth maybe like even 50. That's just wonderful. Bring in another $5,000 worth of nothing, you know, and just crank us out. To yet again, how many hyper-rich do we have? How many hyper-rich do we have now? I mean, to build hyper-rich, you have to have... yeah, you have to have a lot of people buying glamour items to build the hyper-rich. All right. Otherwise, you're only with a few, just a few, like maybe, you know, three or four when you used to have 30, you know. So then that starts to look like a weird government. It starts to look like the more and more of that, you know, you have the tiny, tiny bit of hyper-rich. When you have a tiny, tiny amount of hyper-rich, we start to look more and more like Russia. We start to look more and more like... where's my vodka? You know, we start to look more and more like Russia, where you have that Politburo of the hyper-rich running the game. And saying these are the products that are allowed in and these are the products that are allowed out. Yeah, they get a huge sway over the banks, over everything, because they have so much money moving in and out of loans, blah, 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 blah. So we have all of these, you know, super power, hyper-rich people having, being condensed, consolidated, because there are less glamour products being purchased. So with the more hyper-rich, with the less hyper-rich, they have more power. They have more power because it's less voices. When there's more voices, it's almost like chaos. You know, I want this, I want this one, I want this one, I want this one, you know. But when there's just a few of you in your tight little quarters getting together, it does start to become a bit of a superpower event. And it really just for yourselves. And so then we do have the meagering of the middle class turning into more and more lower middle class, lower and lower into poverty class. So we lose a lot of the middle class through the glamorization items being, I don't know, just going by the wayside. Like I said, how many factories, how many warehouses down there in like Gilroy or whatever are just laying blank, just empty. You know, I mean, that's just a scandal. That's an absolute scandal. So what was I saying next? Oh, I wanted to talk about, I know this is a long video, but I wanted to talk about France in coordination, France itself. When we're looking at it as a guideline, I don't know if I can bring France in right now to this discussion, but I wanted to bring them up that was it. Huge government. Many people work for the French government. So that's how France is surviving, is it has such a good middle class stated because they have so many government workers. So they've expanded their government to a huge, huge, huge socialism structure. And that socialism structure has employed a lot of people with their government. So they have a high government per person going on. So that's how, in a way, they've survived. That's a way how they've survived. So if you have somebody, or because their government workers are just getting paid just huge good wages, and they have a lot of them. So that's the salvage. I don't want that to be the salvage for the United States, is to hire a whole bunch of government workers extra. No. So anyway, just like that, you know, like I said, an appraisal office, a plate for plate, you know, $7 plate offered here, $7 being shipped on off of those cargo ships, you know, that's it. Why are you guys getting a cheaper deal? You know, I'm tired of it. You know, we've undermined ourselves. So yeah, we really have to amend it.